it's not for sale here.
Well, I can't.
That's good.
Well, actually, it's some, I mean, it's one of the first three counties that have to show.
Yeah, anyway, if you tell me, if you can just tell me what your insurance is, maybe some impact, because I have it, and then if you just.
Almost 40 years. Yeah, I came in 19.
Oh, I didn't.
I came in 81.
Yeah.
And Dan came in, I was about 80. Was I in the boat? I don't. I just go, yeah.
He says anytime.
Yeah.
No, he tells me how to go tomorrow.
The old man, yeah. Yeah, German heritage, yeah. He used to have five dresses of glory. He used to have a kid in each door. When they were babies. Yeah, you would have to make, you know, the babies would be in the first and third drawer, you know. But that's, you know, that's 42 women. We tried your best when we had seven, you were raising seven kids.
Yeah.
And five were really a lot of people. God, so many kids. Have you never been a Uganda Dan? Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, you're going to have to come up for the dinner. That's great. Joe has a great one. The Dan gave it to Joe. Joe has a nice one. I'm just going to.
Be resolved in a way that she didn't feel as bad.
That's how they come to the phone. Something back here.
Then you're stuck forever? I mean, I just mean, like, I don't mean to stop, but I mean, seeing it through.
Patrick, hey. Hello. You, of course, yes, go ahead.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Oh, likewise. Goodbye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
Tell me what you see. This one. What is that, April? This one is lalaki. Diba? Lalaki.
Yeah, we have a heavy job.
she has to do hers every year, I think. Every year or something.
Yeah.
I talked to Sophie last night because of that. This baby, she was out with calming times. She has to go.
Patrick?
Yeah.
Hey there.
Hey.
Say hi.
Hi.
It's Patrick, the artist. Well, give them a tour. Okay.
We're gonna do the tour?
Yeah, the dioramas.
Let's start at the beginning. You want to go in here first?
Okay, dioramas.
All right, first we're gonna go into the room that is filled with dioramas. It has four dioramas installed in the wall. The gallery built this wonderful...
April says hi.
Who?
April.
Hi, April. And so what we're gonna do is walk inside, look through these windows, and we'll be able to see these landscapes or scenes
that are... And that is the back, right?
Yes, you can see the outside of the room, the walls revealed, a galley, the gallery constructed.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, we'll go inside.
Okay, now let's go inside.
And what is the inspiration for this one? Okay, in Sweden?
Well, for this particular work, this was inspired by, I had to feel like I have to change something. This was inspired by a drawing that was done of a cave in Scotland called
Scotland's
Cave. Yeah.
Cave in Scotland?
A cave in Scotland. It's called Fingal's Cave, it's a famous cave. And the cave is...
Jail, do you know that, Jail?
The cave is made up of these very strange basalt rock formations. Mm-hmm. They're hexagonal.
Oh, okay, really?
And yes, and everything has worn, gone away, but those particular geometric forms are still remaining. And it's, and if you look out at a distance, you can see the island of Iona. In
yes,
Scotland.
In Scotland, you're right, April. Hexagonal, you said?
Hexagonal, yeah.
Like six sides, okay.
Six sides, that's right.
And we move to...
All right, next is we're going to go to the new landscape, a different kind of landscape. And if you walk up closer, and like the cave piece, which was made out of clay, this one's made out of wax. So it's very, it's translucent, and a lot of the light coming through, it glows. And Fernando's going to zoom in a little bit. You can see on the right-hand side is a cliff in a forest with a stream down the middle. But there's a large ear protruding from the cliff. Now, all of these, so all of these, all of the pieces, all of the dioramas in this exhibition deal with the body, the human body, and the landscape, and how they're interchangeable. That is to say, how the body becomes a place, and landscape becomes an object on the side. So the next, on that theme, I want to walk over here a little bit of a smaller piece.
Noel. Okay, what is this?
And Fernando will zoom in. You can see there's a tree stump with a limb coming out, and there's a moon. It's hard to see, but there's a full moon in the distance.
It's a woman.
But you can see a vulva in the stump. And this stump is made out of wax as well. It's translucent and very warm, flesh tones. So again, it's pink and...
Wax, you said.
And made out of wax, yes. It's very, very corporeal, very body, very inspired by the human body. In this case, by the female genitalia.
Mm-hmm.
Finally, this is the fourth diorama in the room. And this one is entitled Moon and Stars Over a Sunken Landscape. And in this landscape, you can see
which is very dreamlike, very surreal. But a face, which is actually cast from my face, and genitalia. There's an anus, a rectum, and then also a penis.
Okay.
In the landscape.
Yeah.
So very, very dreamlike, surreal, very body related.
And how much does it go for?
So the dioramas are different prices. This one is, it's a 7.5-inch diameter lens. So it's a large one, it's 45,000.
45, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I have one in the Philippines, but it's a different theme.
Oh really, what is the theme?
Diorama. I'm sorry, dandelion.
All right, come here.
Dandelion, not genitalia. You didn't share.
I have no idea.
You didn't share with your father.
Well, my parents might be watching.
No, you didn't share it.
Now, we're going into the main gallery.
You have to do it again.
So we have lots of prints and bronzes, and I want to introduce you guys to the printmaker, the illustrious, famous Dan Pollock, who I worked with, and without his help, we could not have produced all of the, or any of the prints.
But without Patrick, none of these prints, I mean, in my opinion, you've got to have inspiration. You've got to have somebody who gets what you're doing.
Yeah.
And Patrick gets it.
Mm-hmm.
Totally gets it. And that's allowed he and I to loosen up with it.
Mm-hmm.
Have some fun. Do some stuff.
It also helps when you have a glass of bourbon.
Bourbon, yeah.
Of course, I mean, bourbon always helps.
My glass is empty, I don't
know. Yeah, yeah, so is mine.
Can you tell me about this lens, Patrick?
I think you made a false move relinquishing.
Patrick, what is this?
All right, so, and installed in the wall here is basically just the reducing lens that we use, that I use to build the dioramas. Only this time there's nothing behind the lens. That is to say, there's just the lens and you get a sense of exactly how it functions.
Okay.
And how it bends light and how it reduces what you see as you look through the glass.
On his show is Aquaman.
And you still seen this in your studio? They've seen this in your studio.
And so here we have nine viscosity prints, which are the Night Spirit.
Night Spirit.
The title of the exhibition is Nocturnes. And so all the dioramas have moons. They're moonlit landscapes, for example. The bronzes are sort of nocturnal. The silhouettes that they present. And these prints, for the most part, are like night spirits. They're characters that come out of it. Out of the landscape and the light of the moon.
Okay. Are you
and they're whimsical and they're irreverent. They're up to no good. But they're not dark per se. They're colorful, they're vibrant, but they're very strange.
Okay, good. Okay, I guess that's it. Thank you. Say goodbye, baby.
Bye.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank
bye.
You guys. Thanks for coming.
You know, accumulation of